Okay, so we are here in Fort Myers, Florida. It is February 16th, 2016, and here we have a very famous internal medicine specialist who is working in Naples, Florida. And he also, by sheer chance, grew up in Philadelphia, where I grew up, and went to the same high school that I went to, which was a very famous boys' school called Central High School for Boys in Philadelphia. So, when did you start to have the problem with these eye floaters?
I've had them all my life, but I really noticed them after I had cataract surgery, and that was in the fall of 2013.
Okay. What did, and that was done up in Philly, right?
No,
It was
that was actually done in Atlanta.
Atlanta, okay. What did the guys say about your problem when you tried to deal with it?
I went to an ophthalmologist in Naples about it specifically, and was told that either they could take the vitreous out and replace it with saline, or I would just have to learn to live with it.
And there's your floaters right there. These big clumps, which were scattered, kind of interesting. Was that a retina specialist or just a
No, that was a
regular?
general ophthalmologist affiliated with a well-known eye clinic in Miami.
Oh, I see. You mean Bascom
Bascom-Palmer.
Palmer? Actually, Bascom Palmer knows I do this. I've gotten some patients in a roundabout way from the doctor there who I know. I've invited him up here. He has not yet come with Dr. Getty, who's a well-known retinal specialist there. They're still invited. But he's seen my work, but he didn't mention that, did he?
No, well, I didn't see him specifically, but no, the only two options I was given was the vitrectomy and nothing.
So somehow you found me.
Yes, just by searching on the internet.
That's amazing. And you're just down the road, of course. So your situation, and I can explain, it was a little different than the average patient. You didn't have, I don't believe, a posterior vitreous detachment. You had these scattered clumps, and you can see a little clump there. It's coming in and out of your the field of vision there. There goes one. It looks like a big cotton ball. So we performed laser on the right eye and the left eye. And what is your overall quality impression as far as improvement of your subjective opinion of this?
Overall, I have a very high opinion. Previously, the floaters were interfering with my direct line of sight and bothering me quite a bit. Now, I still have a fair number of floaters left, but they're out of my direct line of sight and don't bother me at all, really.
Yeah, and patients always ask me, well, what is the success rate? And my response is usually this: it depends on how we define success and what we start with. I usually try to give an accurate prognosis. I felt that I could get you at a much higher level or a reasonably higher level. And laser's easy. There's not too much effort in it for the patient other than being here. There's no risk of
No,
infection.
I didn't have any problems at all that I noticed.
Yes, and I love a medical doctor testimonial. You're not suffering from placebo effect, are you?
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure this is real.
Okay. But you did talk to one of your ophthalmologist buddy friends from elsewhere and told him you had this, but the funny thing is they never pick up the phone and give me a call and say, well, what did you do with my friend here? I still don't understand that because I would have been curious myself, but does give me a good lock on the market. What can I say? Well, thank you for being a great patient, and thank you for this beautiful testimonial.